My name is Krist, and I work as a reverse engineer at Apriorit. I decided to become a reverse engineer when I was working on a project that was dealing with a very, very old program. And my goal was to improve the interoperability of this program. Now, in order to do this, I had to understand the product much better. During the project, I had sort of an epiphany, and I realized that I enjoyed this kind of a puzzle-solving task. And I thought it would be really fun if I could do this in the future as work. And when I was on Apriorit's blog, looking for something that pertained to the topic, I came across a vacancy and I applied and I started working at Apriorit as a reverse engineer. Reverse engineering is the detailed analysis of a certain system or protocol. Its goal is to discover how something was built and how it operates, and how it interoperates with other things. Once you've examined the software device, you can begin to search for vulnerabilities, extend its code, and expand it for interoperability purposes. At Apriorit, we use reverse engineering for projects that are related to malware research, closed data formats, compatibility extension, and code patching. I remember working on a project that was involving a ping tool in a router, and essentially I discovered that this ping tool wasn't protected very well. And essentially, due to a certain vulnerability related to how this ping tool handled input, a malicious actor could take control over the device remotely. A large problem with many devices is that there just isn't enough research. A few years ago, WannaCry impacted many devices and crippled many critical systems. Had there been more research performed, then I think these vulnerabilities could have been patched, they could have been resolved, and avoided, ultimately, altogether. I would say that the following skills are required to be a good reverse engineer. You need to be able to recognize problems and solve them quickly. You need to be able to write algorithms and recognize them in their decompiled or disassembled state. You need to be able to read C, assembly, and C++. And you need to at least be able to program effectively, well, in a programming language. You need to have gained knowledge of different operating systems and their system tools and how those tools work. And you need to have a good common knowledge of application structures, programming languages, and different compilers. Reverse engineering is sort of a unique field, and you need to be able to learn quickly, and you need to be comfortable working with a device or software that you do not fully understand. Now, the path of a reverse engineer is somewhere between a security analyst and a programmer. While I think that it is a difficult field, I think that it is also a very rewarding field. If you like to deal with challenges and you like to work in a fast-paced environment, then I think reverse engineering might be what you need.